Okay, so if you want to create a Google Doc, the first thing that you want to do is go to docs.google.com in your browser. And that'll bring you to the starting page of Google Docs. And there's just a few things I want to point out here. You might not see anything in the recent documents if this is your very first time. But what you will see here is two different options to start with. You can start with a blank document, which is what we're going to do. Or you can start with a template. These templates will have a little bit of content and some styling done in them already. And they could be super helpful, but we're going to start from scratch so that we can show you what to do. So I've left clicked on blank and it brings up this clean slate. There's no title yet, so let's go up to the title and let's just give it the name of tutorial. And once you type it, if you click out of it, it's saved with that new name in the cloud in your Google account. You don't have to go to file and save. There is no option to save here because every time you type or change something, it's saved automatically. So let's get out of that menu, left click on the document again. And the blinking cursor means that it's just waiting for you to type. Some of the basic formatting is already done for you. So there's a standard font selected, standard font size, and it's waiting for you to type normal text. So normal text would be the body of the document. So if I take my mouse and I left click and drag, this is the way that you select text if you want to change all of it. And let's just say that this is actually going to be the title. Go up to where it says normal text. These are preset styles. And let's just change it to a title. Sorry guys, that's actually the title of the document. And then at the end of the line, when you're done with that line, you're ready to start a new one. If you hit the enter key, then Google knows that you've moved on and it's back to normal text again. So let's say actually this is the body of the document. I'm going to do a second line here as another paragraph, and I'm going to use this to show you a few things. So if you notice, the spacing in between the title and the first paragraph is a lot larger than this first paragraph and the second paragraph. That's all controlled by these styles, but you can also control them by going to Format and Line Spacing. If you want more or less space before and after your paragraphs, it's much better to do them here than doing something like if you go to the right and you press enter again. So at this point, we have the title and we have some body text. We're going to add a few more things and it's going to make it easier to see what's going on if we go to View. And let's just open up the document outline. It's going to come on the left-hand side and it's going to show you the different parts of your document. Let's go to the beginning of the body. And we want to insert a line above the body text and below the title. So I'm going to type the enter key right now. This is giving us a space in here. Let's go into that space and we're going to say part one, the start of it all. And I want this to be a header. So go to where it says normal text, these are your styles, and let's get it a heading one. And as you can see, the document outline is starting to build out right now. So here's your title. If I click on that, it'll bring the cursor up to it. And if you go down to part one, it'll bring the cursor down there. Now, admittedly, if you only have one heading and one title, the outline is a little bit excessive right now because you can see what you're doing. As you start to build out your story, the outline is going to be a little bit more helpful. So if you have a second header, now you're going to start seeing it there. Let me go back to the body text. I'm going to hit enter again, and I'm going to put in another type of header. Let's make this a heading two. And if you look at the document outline, it's going to be helpful. It's going to indent the second header because it's a heading two. And then when you go back to a heading one, it's going to be more of a main part of it. So if you ever do a table of contents, it's going to look a lot like your outline. This is going to give you a preview of the structure. Now I'm going to bring up a document that has a lot more text in it so we can go over a couple of different things that you might want to change. So let's go to File. And I brought it up here. I just called it Example Document so you know what it is. So this is an example document and I have a few different things going on here. So one of the things is there's a heading one, which we went over. Then there's some body text. But then I had another header and I wanted to put it on a second page. If I scroll down, you'll see it. But I didn't just hit enter a bunch of times until it went on the second page. If you do that and you add text later, it's going to push everything down and create a problem. You actually want to go to insert break and do a page break. It's already done, so if I do it again, I'll actually have two page breaks. But that's the proper way to add another page. If you backspace, it'll get rid of it. So I'm just do that. Now I only have two pages again. And if you look at these paragraphs, I'm going to highlight all three of them by left-clicking with the mouse and dragging. These are justified on the right, but the last one isn't. So there's two different types of alignment going on here. Let's select the third paragraph. And I'm going to zoom out a little bit so the menu bar shows all the options. And let's look at the different alignments. If I left-click on align, the first two paragraphs are justified. And if you look at this little icon, you see that the right-hand side's lined up, but this paragraph is left-aligned. If you justify these, it'll add a tiny bit of space in between each word, just enough so that it pushes the right-hand side to be equal. And if we want to apply that to the third paragraph as well, just go to alignment, click justify. And there you go, that's done. There's no enter key after each of these lines. You just keep typing, use your spaces and letters as usual, and then you apply the styling afterwards. If you try to do that by using the spacebar and the enter keys, things won't work out very well for you. If you want to do some custom styling, let's just select this first paragraph and let's say, hey, this normal text styling is great, but I really want it to be italicized. You can control all of those attributes by these options that are in the middle of the menu bar. So we could just select italics, click on it. Only the paragraph that you highlighted will be italicized. If you also want the second one to be exactly like this first one, just go to the first paragraph, click on the format painter, and then go to where you also want to apply that style, select it, and it'll paint the format from the first paragraph onto the second paragraph. So the last basic thing that I want to go over that Google Docs will do for you is that it will format a list, sleeping bag and a pillow and a tent are the types of things that I want for this weekend. This is a list of things, and if it's fine this way, then just leave it, but there's a couple different options on how you can make it look like a list. So I've left-clicked, I've selected all three of the lines so that Google Docs knows what I'm wanting to format. And my options are that I can create it as a numbered list. And if I use this little drop-down, there's different types of numbered list. So you can have main steps be a number and then sub-steps be a letter and so forth. Or you could go over to just the bulleted list option. I just left clicked it. You can see that it applied it. And there's different types of bulleted lists as well. So the one that I've applied, if you use a sub item, it's going to be an open circle. So let's add one here so you can see it. So I'm going to press enter after sleeping bag. Then I'm going to press tab. That's going to get me to a second level of this list. And we want it to be a warm sleeping bag because it's the fall and it's going to get down to 40 degrees Fahrenheit tonight. And as you can see, we made a beautiful document. That's all the basics that you need to know to type a paper and have it look good. So I hope that was helpful. If you liked that tutorial and you want to see others like it, you can subscribe to my channel in the lower right-hand corner. Thanks.